Hey guys, this is Saurabh Nahai from Allbot Technologies, and in this video, let's do a speed test comparison between the newly launched Samsung Galaxy M31 and the Poco X2. Now, in terms of pricing, M31 starts at 15,000, whereas Poco X2 starts at 16,000. So the price is very similar, but what about the performance when it comes to app opening and multitasking? Well, let's find out in this video. But before we start, do give this video a like and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And in case if you are planning to buy any of these phones, then as always, all the links will be there in the description box. Now, note that I have reduced the animations on the Samsung Galaxy M31 by going into the settings, and I recommend the same to everyone who plan to buy this phone. I've also turned off all the battery optimizations on Poco X2 to get maximum performance. Both phones are on the same Wi-Fi network, and lastly, there were no applications or data apart from what I will use in this test. With that said, let's start the test. Let's start with Twitter, and as you just saw, Poco X2 was slightly faster, but it's not a huge difference. Let's move on to Instagram, and this time it's clearly Samsung Galaxy M31 who showed the image first. PUBG, which is everyone's favorite, let's see who loads it first. So as expected, it is Poco X2 who loaded it faster, and M31 took few extra seconds to load. Amazon shopping application, once again, Poco X2 loaded the page faster. Now note that both the devices have Widevine L1 certification, which means you can watch full HD content on Amazon Prime Video as well as on Netflix. I'm not sure why it is showing 2.35 GB on Poco X2, but both just support full HD for now. Now to be honest, 120Hz and all is great, but the AMOLED display on the Samsung Galaxy M31 just looks better when you keep both the phones side by side. Anyways, Samsung Galaxy M31 did load the Facebook application faster, but majority of the times Poco X2 loads the applications and games faster, which shows that Snapdragon 730G is a more powerful processor than the Exynos 9611. With YouTube application, once again, M31 was faster, but the difference isn't huge. And as I said earlier, X2 is faster in most of the applications and games. Now, the apps that you see in this list are the apps that I use on a regular basis, and some of the applications are just to test both the phones. Last game that we have on the list is Call of Duty, which is again a demanding game, so let's see who loads it first. And once again, it is Poco X2, which was 3 to 4 seconds faster than the Samsung Galaxy M31. Let's end this round with exporting the video and see who does it faster. Okay, I'm tired of saying once again every time, but yes, again, it is Poco X2 who has crushed the Samsung Galaxy M31 with its performance by exporting the video faster. So overall, X2 is faster in opening games and applications most of the times, and it was hardly in few applications where Samsung Galaxy M31 opened the application faster. Okay, so now starts the most interesting part of this video, which is multitasking, and trust me, this one will shock you. So both the devices have all the applications in the memory till brim, which is nice. But as soon as we move on to Asphalt 8, Poco X2 fails to start the application from where we left. And this has happened multiple times when I did this test. I have recorded the test 7 to 8 times. And every time Poco X2 either reloaded the Brim application or Asphalt 8. So Poco really needs to improve the RAM management on the X2. Now there is some kind of bug with Xiaomi devices where Amazon application goes blank if you try to reopen it. So let's ignore it and check if PUBG is there in memory or not. And once again, Samsung Galaxy M31 had PUBG in memory, but Poco X2 is reloading the PUBG game. So overall, if I have to say, M31 did a fantastic job in terms of memory management, but Poco X2 as expected is a champ when it comes to performance and app opening. Well, RAM management is something that can be fixed, but performance on Samsung Galaxy M31 can't be. Anyways, now let me close all the application and do the Wi-Fi speed test to check which one is faster. Let's start with Poco X2. And the results are here: 73.7 Mbps download and 81.3 Mbps upload. Let's see what speeds we get on the Samsung Galaxy M31 now. It's 43.7 Mbps download and 41.5 Mbps upload, which is slightly more than half of what Poco X2 is offering. It's not just this time it is happening, it has happened multiple times. As I mentioned earlier, I have done this test multiple times and every time Poco X2 outperformed Samsung Galaxy M31 in Wi-Fi speed test. Anyways, time to end this video with AnTuTu and Geekbench scores for those who like to compare the numbers. Personally, to me, these scores don't matter much. Well, that's it for this video. If you found this video helpful, then please do give this video a like and subscribe to the channel for more such amazing test videos that are coming up on the channel. So make sure you subscribe and turn on the notifications. If you are not following me on Twitter and Instagram, make sure you follow me over there for more updates. That's it for this video. This is Saurabh Nahar from All About Technologies. Thank you guys for watching. Bye.